One of the innovative aspects of 3DS Max when it was first released was the concept of the modifier stack. We can layer effects with a metaphor similar to that of a 2D image processing program. I've got a monitor stand. I can select that in the viewports. And in the modify panel, we see it's a very simple modifier stack with a box base object or primitive and a taper modifier. Let's add a bend above that taper and bend the monitor stand up so it reaches the monitor screen. When we add a modifier, it is placed directly above the currently selected position in the stack. We can move modifiers around if we want to, but by default they'll be created above the current level. If I select the box base object, then when I add a modifier, it will be added above the box, but below the taper. Let's add a bend above the taper, so I'll select Taper, and from the modifier list pull down, choose Bend. We need to give it some non-zero amount for the angle, so let's increase the angle up, and we can see it's not bending in the correct direction. We want to change the bend axis and or the bend direction. Just like the taper modifier in the previous movie, we want to align the modifier's axis with the length of the object. And in this case, the length is the y-axis. We'll set the bend axis to y. And now it's aligned correctly, but it's bending in the wrong direction. Let's give it an extreme angle above 90 degrees. And adjust this direction, see how that works. So it looks like with a direction value of 90 degrees, we'll have bent the object in the dimension that we want. I can orbit around and take a look at that. And again, just like the taper modifier, we have limits for the effect. I only want the bend to be constrained within a very small area. I want most of the object to be straight and linear or flat. So I'll turn on limit effect. And we'll adjust these values. Let's leave the lower limit at 0 and increase the upper limit. And we want a very small value here in this case. Only a very small area is going to be bent. The rest of it's going to be flat. I'll set the upper limit to a value of 5 centimeters. All right, we can get in closer, investigate this. Looks like we need to change our bend angle. So we'll adjust that. Let's set the bend angle to 100 degrees. We can see in the left viewport that we're getting the right angle to the bend, but we'll want to move the bend gizmo in order to bring the bent area closer to the screen. So let's go into the bend subobject modes and choose gizmo, and the move tool is selected automatically. Go up to the top view, right-click so you don't lose your selection, and click and drag on the y-axis and see how that works. We can observe the results in the perspective and left viewports. Let's set the gizmo's Y position to exactly 10 centimeters in the transform type-in area down here. Now we have a bend and a taper in a particular order, and the way these are applied is from the bottom up. That's why it's called a stack. We start with a box, and we taper it, and then bend it. If you change the order of those operations, you'll change the outcome, and sometimes in unexpected ways. And if you're particularly unlucky, if you move the modifiers around in the stack, you may get into a situation where even if you move them back, you don't get the same result. That's kind of rare, and it's actually a program error. But you do want to be on the lookout for those kind of situations. I recommend you save your scene before you start moving modifiers around, just to be safe. Let's see what happens if I do move those around. I can select the bend modifier, and click and drag, hold the mouse down, and I get a blue line when my cursor is positioned between two modifiers or base object. So I can drag that bend down below the taper and release the mouse, and now I get a completely different result. We can see in the perspective view it's changed drastically, because now we're bending the object and then tapering it. Okay, I'll move that back up again, click and drag, position that up at the top. And we're restored back to our previous condition. That's the basic concept of the modifier stack, effects that can be layered on top of one another. In the case of these parametric deformers, any changes we make in the modify panel are non-destructive and reversible. For example, we could go back to our taper modifier and adjust the taper amount. increase or decrease that, maybe set it to a value of 2 exactly. That's how to layer parametric deformers in the modifier stack.